Hi, I'm Maria Ingold. We're at Connected Media IP at NAB 2018, and I'm here with Dan Finch, the Chief Commercial Officer from SimpleStream. Dan, welcome. How is the show going for you?
Hi, it's going really well. It's great to be here. We've known each other for a long time, so it's nice to catch up with you here. And huge amounts going on in the industry. We're here, just launched our international office based out of Toronto. So we've got a big presence here this year, which is hugely exciting. And hoping to replicate what we've achieved in the UK, but bring it over to the North America and the American market.
That's so exciting. Like you said, we've known each other since you and Adam launched SimpleStream 8 years ago.
I know.
Oh my gosh. So I know how you've evolved, but tell who's watching how you've evolved over that time.
Yeah, so I guess we started with the ambition we started in live streaming and then created quite a cool live to VOD solution. Mm-hmm. And then as time has progressed, customers' expectations have changed, people's viewing habits have changed, and we've adapted our business model and business products and services to meet those changing requirements. Although we started in live, we are doing a lot more in video on demand services these days, for example, and syndication of content.
Yeah, because TV Player had come out of that, and
so that's kind of something that we did in our sort of spare time. So in the time where we didn't have maybe the customers that we wanted on SimpleStream, it was about going out and doing those deals with the broadcasters. So SimpleStream certainly has helped to keep the lights on, and then now the two businesses are doing very different things, but both really, really great. So we're very proud of them both.
I'm proud of them for you too.
Yeah, thank you.
So you've done so much so far, and you've clearly got new things in mind with having a new office in Canada.
Yep.
And expansion.
Yep.
So what else is on the roadmap for 2018?
So we're looking to essentially replicate what we've achieved in the UK, but I think a bit more as well. And for us, it's about proving the business model works in a market like the UK, and then essentially just meeting the changing requirements that customers and broadcasters are having to face these days. Linear TV is still there, but there's few shows these days where people want to come and watch perhaps live, unless it's sport, unless it's news. So we see a real shift towards maybe different business models, either ad supported or subscription for those broadcasters.
That's great. So what are you showcasing here specifically?
So
the new exciting stuff.
Yeah, so we've basically built out a white label cloud TV platform.
Ooh.
So if you've got multiple live channels, you need a live to VOD solution, you need a full kind of payment gateway or operator authenticated apps. So we're now doing all of those things. Also here to promote our VOD in a box product that has, I don't know if it's the way we've maybe productized it and have presented it, but it's really got a lot of traction. So we've got 5 new customers that we've signed up in the last 4 months, and they're all about testing SVOD services, AVOD services. I guess you've got the trend that has been set by Netflix and Amazon. Mm-hmm. But for every niche content owner, there's a huge opportunity to find that audience via non-traditional broadcast methods to build a substantial business. So that's really what we're like the enabler to help them do that.
And tell everyone what your key differentiator is as well. How are you different from all the other people in this space?
Yeah, so you could probably go around this whole South Hall here and get all the bits that you need to have a service, or you can come and see us and we can provide the whole kind of managed piece. I guess we've kind of spent the last few years doing our own kind of RFP processes with all the different suppliers, and we work with the best of breed. We have our software that we sell, but if a company is out there doing a better job than we probably could, then we're going to probably partner with them rather than try and reinvent it and try and build it. Because I think one key message that I've learned from NAB this year is collaboration. I think, frenemies,
so true.
Collaboration, it's like it's we're in a funny space now. You've got the big players, your fangs that are here.
Yep.
And they're certainly here to stay. So I think it's very much a collaborative effort is probably needed to, you know, to sort of compete these days. Yeah. Whereas in the old days, it was slightly different.
So true.
Yeah.
So you've been around since early days too. So what are your predictions for this next year?
So I think we'll see a continual kind of decline in linear TV. I think we'll see. Decline in linear TV from a more traditional, you know, sort of delivery method. I think there is certainly a space for live OTT.
Oh yeah.
Very much focused still around sport and news though. Mm-hmm. But for everything else, I think there's you know, more and more of these subscription services that will be launching. I think mobile operators, there's interesting play there, and it's just all those exciting things that are happening now in the market are shaping the way that TV and video is being delivered and consumed. So it's great to be part of that kind of journey.
Yeah,
we're in a very sort of disruptive space, but I think as well we're almost like the antidote to the problem for some broadcasters who are looking to actually understand their audience, perhaps even for the first time. So you know, broadcast by its definition, it's a one-way street. You don't understand who your audience is unless, you know, you have that return path data that the services like OTT services can actually deliver. That can then help you maybe shape your content strategy, helps you understand your customer. And this is kind of what Netflix have really been doing for the last, you know, 4 or 5 years. And everyone's now suddenly gone, hold on a second, that's what we should be doing. And then they go, well, should we, you know, be part of that, or should we be doing our own thing? So I think it's a very interesting time for broadcasters at the moment to try and get to grips with all these different ways to understand their audience and actually monetize their content.
Well, here's to understanding the customer better and to the next 8 years.
Great.
I look forward to it. So thank you so much for joining us.
Pleasure. Lovely speaking to you.
We look forward to seeing you next year as well.
Great. Okay. We'll be right back.